With your
president, please be seated.
Le président.
President, please be seated. And the court is now in session. Today, the chamber will hear the remaining testimony of the current witness and begin hearing testimony of another witness, that is through TCW 945. Ms. Jie Xiehuang, please report the attendance of the parties and other individuals at today's proceedings. Greffier, Mr. President, for today's proceedings, all parties to discuss are present. Mr. Nuji is present in the holding cell downstairs. He has waived his right to be present in the courtroom. The waiver has been delivered to the greffier. The civil party who is to conclude his testimony today, that is Ms. Kyung Yang Chet, is present in the courtroom. Today we also have a reserve witness, that is to TCW 945, who confirms to the best of his knowledge he has no relationship by blood or by law to any of the two accused. There is no Jian Kyung Paul nor to any other civil parties admitted in this case. The witness took an oath before the Iron Club statue yesterday. Thank you.
La statue du génie à la barre de fer.
President, thank you, Ms. Jie Xiehuang.
Le président. Merci.
The chamber now decides on the request by Nuji.
La chambre va maintenant se prononcer sur
the chamber has received a waiver from Nuji dated 8 December 2015, which states that due to his health, he cannot sit or concentrate for long, and in order to effectively participate in future hearings, he requests to waive his right to participate in and be present at the 8 December 2015 hearing.
Il demande à pouvoir suivre les débats à distance.
Having seen the medical report on Nuji by the duty doctor for the accused at the ECCC dated 8 December 2015,
par lequel le médecin souligne
Nuji has back pain and dizziness when he sits for long, and recommends that the chamber grant him his request that he can follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs. Based on the above information, and pursuant to Rule 85.5 of the ECCC internal rules, the chamber grants Nuji his request to follow today's proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs via audiovisual means. The chamber instructs the AV unit personnel to link the proceedings to the room downstairs so that Nuji can follow. This applies to the whole day. I'd like now to hand the floor to the defense team for Nuji to put questions to this civil party if you still have a question to put to him.
Yes, I do. Thank you, Mr. President, and good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Council. Good morning, Mr. Civil Party. Yesterday, we ended discussing Da Ping and his function. I will get back to him shortly. I would like to return to the discussion we had before. About the time that the events that you described yesterday took place. In your interview with your lawyer, you said that the killing of your family took place in March
75.
5 months earlier, you also talked to some people, probably people from what is called the victim's support section.
De la section d'appui
and
aux victimes.
In that document,
D22/317/5/1,
there's no French and no Khmer. It's English, ERN 0056 1343. In that document, you describe two incidents,
two killings,
one of your family and one 6 months later. And the killing of your family in that report is dated at the beginning of 1975.
But
my question is about the time period more general. You described that the events took place in what was called District 18. Is it correct that the area, what is called District 18, was already liberated by the Khmer Rouge in 1971? So much earlier than 75.
Bien avant 1975.
So Sector 71 was already governed by cadres like Taiping. Is that correct?
Est-ce bien le cas?
President Sivapati, please wait, and the lead co-lawyer for Sivapati, you have the floor.
La co-avocate principale pour les parties civiles.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Une courte observation sur la nature du document qui a été lu par notre confrère. Comme je l'ai dit à plusieurs reprises dans cette audience, ces rapports qui sont effectués par la section de soutien aux victimes sont des rapports, c'est-à-dire qu'il n'y a pas de contact direct entre l'unité des victimes et la partie civile. C'est simplement un résumé qui est fait de la constitution de partie civile. Simplement pour que ce soit clair, puisque à ce moment-ci, il n'y a pas de contact entre l'unité des victimes et la partie civile.
Mr. President, I take the lead co-lawyer's word for it. I just read whatever I was reading in that report, but my question is not so much about that report. My question is, to the civil party, wasn't Sector 18, or sorry, District 18, already liberated
by
National Front forces or Khmer Rouge forces in 71?
So
four years before 75.
Khmer Rouge dès 1971, donc 4 ans avant 1975.
I refer to the year of 1975, and I did not mention anything regarding what you had just
extracted.
President, Mr. Sivapati, you have not responded to the question. And Councillor Copper, please repeat your question. And the civil party, please listen to the question carefully. And if you know, you say yes. And if you don't, you say no. But first, you need to understand the question before you can respond correctly. Councillor Copper, please repeat it.
Of course, Mr. President, I will rephrase. Yesterday, you spoke about events that took place in Kampong Ling District, and you said that it was also known as District 18. Is it correct that District 18 or Kampong Ling District was already liberated by the quote-unquote Khmer Rouge in 1971?
Kampong Leng district is District 16, says the civil party. And I said people from District 18 also came to live in District 16. That's what I said when I was asked by my lawyer.
As a matter of fact, I think yesterday you said that Kampong Ling district is also known as District 18,
district de Kampong Ling était aussi
which I think it is,
as a civil party.
Do you know the secretary of Kampong Ling district in 1972?
Savez-vous qui était le secrétaire
who was in charge of that district in
1972? De Kampong Ling en 1972? Qui était à la tête du district en 1972?
I was young at that time.
J'étais bien jeune à l'époque. Je ne savais pas qui il était.
Have you ever heard of a man named Book?
Entendu parler d'un
Book
homme
being the 1972
Book,
secretary of district 18.
Le secrétaire du district 18 en 1972.
No.
Réponse, non.
That name is not familiar.
Je ne connais pas ce nom.
Have you ever
question.
Heard of a person,
avez-vous jamais entendu parler
Bun Tan,
de Bun
alias
Tan,
Chan,
alias Chan,
who was probably
qui était
the Sector 31
sans doute,
chief in which
le chef du secteur 31,
District 18 was situated.
Dans lequel se trouvait le District 18.
Frankly speaking,
réponse.
I was a young boy at
à dire vrai,
time,
j'étais
so
jeune garçon
I didn't know
à l'époque.
Who was in the senior
je
positions.
Ne savais pas qui occupait les rangs
even
des
my father,
dirigeants,
he would
des dirigeants.
Be aware of that,
même mon père
n'aurait
sans doute pas été au courant de cela,
living
car nous, nous nous concentrions à gagner notre vie.
I understand, Mr. Civil Party.
Oui,
let me now return
monsieur.
Again to Tapping.
Donc laissez-moi
do you know whether Tapping himself was Vietnamese?
Savez-vous si Tapping lui-même était vietnamien?
I met him and
je l'ai rencontré.
I cannot say for sure.
Je ne saurais le dire avec certitude.
Whether he's Chinese or
je
he a Khmer or Vietnamese person, I did not
Khmer
even dare look at his face, so I cannot tell you
visage, je ne
about
dire.
Him.
Have you ever heard someone
question.
Say that he used to serve in the Vietnamese army?
Il était soldat dans l'armée vietnamienne?
No, I haven't.
Je n'ai jamais entendu. Question.
Assuming that I might be correct,
si l'on tient pour acquis que j'ai
party,
raison,
and that sector, the District 18 was already in the hands
18.
Of the quote-unquote Khmer Rouge.
Était déjà sous le contrôle des soi-disant Khmer Rouge.
Is it possible that the events that you described took place
est-il donc possible
long time
que
before
les événements
1975?
Que vous avez décrits aient pu avoir lieu bien avant 1975? Le président.
President, si vous partez, please hold on.
Veuillez attendre le juge Lavergne. Vous avez la parole.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Je suis désolé, Maître Copé, de l'interrompre votre interrogatoire, mais je voulais juste une précision, à savoir quel était le fondement de vos questions pour affirmer, pour alléguer que Tapim était un soldat vietnamien.
Asserting or alleging that Tapim was of Vietnamese origin.
Judge Lavergne, as you know, the investigators of the investigating judge never investigated
comme vous savez, le juge
the events described
jamais
by
enquêté
the civil party.
Sur les événements décrits par cette partie civile.
We had to do our own research
nous avons dû donc
by necessity.
Faire nos propres recherches et
and
ce,
based on the case
besoin.
File, we
car nous fondons sur le dossier pénal,
are inclined
sur
to think
culture.
That District 18 was in fact already in the hands of the quote-unquote Khmer Rouge in 71.
croire que ce district 18 était déjà entre les mains des soi-disant Khmer Rouge dès 1971 et que Taping aurait pu être vietnamien et membre de l'armée vietnamienne. C'est quelque chose que nous retrouvons aussi dans le dossier.
Je vais vous poser une question, je vous demande une réponse.
I have just put a question to you and I expect you to answer it.
From the case file.
Dans le dossier.
Ce n'est pas une réponse, Maître Copé.
That is not an answer, Counsel Copé.
But you have to do it with this answer, Judge Obey.
Mais c'est la seule réponse que j'ai à vous donner.
Eh bien, dans ce cas, je pense qu'il vous sera redit que si vous voulez poser des questions, il faut que nous puissions comprendre le fondement.
We will need to know the basis of any questions you put to the witness.
May I just ask one additional question?
La juge Vance, because I'm not sure I got it right. Question de plus, je crois avoir
Are you referring to a personal case file now as a basis for questions? Are you referring to the case file we all base these proceedings
dans
on?
Lequel nous nous fondons
exactly.
Notre copie, oui, précisément.
Que what?
La juge Vance, lequel?
It's the case file. Le dossier. Defined in terms of E3 numbers.
Tel que défini
well,
par les documents en E3.
Kindly provide us the E3 number, which is the basis for your question. This is what this is all about.
C'est justement ce que l'on vous demande.
Sorry, if you insist, it's E3/E3/1852.
President, please provide the ERN in three languages
a common practice in this courtroom.
There is only an English ERN.
Il n'y a qu'un
it's
008-189-33.
Mr. President, I just wanted to note for the record, because it hasn't been stated outright, that the document that counsel has just referred to is a S21 confession document. We have, of course, addressed this issue before. These are documents that are implicitly suspect. Often the information contained in them is obtained under torture. And I believe that that should be the conclusion of the line of questioning based on this document.
Sur ce document.
The main gist of my question was,
oui, mais l'essentiel
Mr. President, whether district 18 was
président
in
était...
fact.
President,
le président.
Counsel Copper,
Maître Copper,
the line of questionings you put to the civil party.
Ces questions que vous posez à la partie civile.
Is not that proper, and that you also do not provide sufficient ground for your questioning to the civil party. And in order to ascertain the truth in this matter, it is better for you to avoid such lines of questioning.
Afin d'assurer une bonne manifestation
and
de la vérité.
Please, you can put further questions to the civil party without referring to torture-tainted document from S21. You can rely on an evidence derived by torture from S21.
Vous ne pouvez pas fonder vos questions sur des documents obtenus par torture.
I'm not sure how you can see so quickly that Le Hoare was in fact tortured, but
the main gist,
as I was explaining, Mr. President, of my question was, and that I have, I'm basing myself upon Kiernan, that that particular part of the West Zone was already liberated in 71.
Maître Copé, est-ce que par hasard Ben Kiernan se fonde sur les mêmes sources,
Ben Kiernan,
à savoir des aveux de S21, ou est-ce qu'il a d'autres sources? Si c'est le cas, on serait heureux de les entendre.
There are in fact many other sources, Judge Lavergne. There's in fact
sources,
a map.
Juge,
I think it's an American intelligence map
describing
the period 70-75. And you can see on that map that, except for the big cities, most parts of Cambodia were in fact under the control of the National Front Forces. And if you look at that map, and I'm sure Keenan did as well as others,
that part of the country
was in the hands of the National Front, including Kampong Ling
district.
District 18, Sector 31, by the way, not 71, as I understand, it was translated. So no, Keenan is not basing himself upon confessions.
Mr. President,
le président.
Deputy co-prosecutor, if you are on your feet, please sum up all your points.
Vous levez pour parler.
At the same time,
veuillez résumer tout
for
ce
one
que
time,
vous voulez
please,
dire.
Do not
prenez la parole une seule fois.
And raise another matter related to the same issue.
Un autre argument sur cette même question.
Thank you, Mr. President. I actually just wanted to make a quick point of clarification in relation to the premise of the question. I actually believe that what the civil party stated initially this morning, which is that Kampong Leng is in District 16, is correct.
And so,
while this debate can be had later, potentially through filings, I think that the premise of the question may be incorrect.
Mais je pense que la prémisse même du débat est Maître Copé.
If I may briefly respond and then I will move on, Mr. President, it was this civil party in his supplementary statement who says that Kampong Ling district was also known as District 18, something that he repeated in response to a question from his lawyer. Kampong Ling was District 18, which by the way is also confirmed by this document that I'm not allowed to use. But my question to you, Mr. Civil Party, isn't it correct
that
the place where you were living was already liberated by forces of the National Front or the Khmer Rouge, whatever you want to call it, in
1971.
In 1971, I did not arrive in Kampong Chnam yet. Actually, I arrived in Kampong Chnam 1 month before the Khmer New Year celebration.
Avant le Nouvel An Khmer.
And then, after 7 days after the Khmer New Year celebration, then the river moved or evacuated.
Then my last question on this subject,
ma dernière question
would
sur
it be possible,
est la suivante.
Or is it likely that you're referring to Khmer New Year maybe in 71
est-il
or 72,
possible que vous fassiez référence au Nouvel An Khmer de 71, 72, 13, 14?
Non, non.
Le président, le parti civil.
Cannot tell you about that. What I can say is that in 1971 I was in my hometown, that is Rusaidongkut village.
I will move on to the next subject, Mr. Civil Party. As you might have heard earlier,
comme vous l'avez entendu,
the events that you described have not been investigated at all by this court before. So we only have your testimony to rely on.
Nous ne pouvons nous fonder que sur votre
déposition. Is there anyone in your surroundings, maybe Mr. Dali or anyone to whom you told the story, to whom you described the events that you described yesterday?
Is there anyone de ces événements à qui que ce soit, ces événements que vous avez décrits
corroborate
hier,
your evidence?
Y a-t-il quelqu'un qui pourrait corroborer votre témoignage?
I know Tali, but Tali passed away, and I do not know anyone else.
Et je ne connais personne d'autre.
When you returned to Cambodia in 1982,
quand vous êtes rentré au Cambodge en 1982,
whom you told the story? Is there anyone who could confirm?
Votre histoire à quelqu'un?
Is there anyone
who quelqu'un qui peut confirmer
saw the events? Anyone at all
qui a vu
that we can ask a question?
Pouvez-vous nous donner le nom d'une personne à qui on pourrait poser des questions à ce sujet?
Le President, président, civil parties, please wait until the phone is
on. D'attendre que votre microphone soit allumé
civil party,
pour prendre la parole. La partie civile.
I was very poor and I worked as a laborer to earn my living.
J'ai travaillé comme ouvrier pour gagner ma vie et c'est tout.
Yesterday, Mr. Civil Party, you were asked a question about
vous a posé des questions.
What you call your memory loss.
À propos de vos pertes de mémoire.
In your statement,
vous appelez
E3/5631, at the very end,
5, 6, 3,
you say, I forget approximately 30% of things.
J'oublie environ 30%
as a result of your injuries. When
mémoire.
You say that you forget approximately 30% of things, where does that come
quand
from? Why 30% and
30%.
Why not maybe 50%
pourquoi
or 10%?
50,
what makes you say that you forget things, that you forget approximately 30% of things?
30% des choses.
Because that's
réponse.
The truth.
C'est la vérité.
Because of the injury,
I
tend to forget, and I myself know about my personal memory loss.
J'ai bien conscience de mes pertes de mémoire.
In that same paragraph, Mr. Civil Party, you also speak about mental issues that you are having, particularly, quote unquote, when I'm doing too much work.
Surtout quand vous dites, notamment lorsque je travaille trop.
With mental issues.
Que voulez-vous dire?
What kind of mental issues do you have?
Pouvez-vous nous dire quels sont vos troubles psychologiques?
I feel the tension on the nape of my neck, and sometimes I become dizzy.
Et parfois j'ai des étourdissements.
I understand, but that what you're describing something that we call physical injuries. You're talking about mental injuries.
Comme
is there something
sometimes
not going well in your head?
Blessure mentale, c'est-à-dire parfois ne pas vous sentir bien dans votre tête. Est-ce que c'est cela?
It's due to the injury that I was hit three times with an axe. That's the main cause.
Lorsque j'ai été frappé à trois reprises avec une hache, c'est la principale cause. Question.
Let me move on now to the events that you described. In the report on civil party application that I just referred to, made up by people from the victim support section who apparently never spoke to you, but they, in their report, make a distinction between two events that you described. One at the beginning of 1975, when allegedly your family was killed, and one in July 75, when around 40 villagers were killed. And in that report, it is described that you were part of the group of 40 villagers when you were hit on the back of your neck, rather than at the beginning of 75, when your family was allegedly killed. So my question is, when you were hit on in the back of your neck, did that happen when you were with your family or when you were part of a group of 40 villagers?
Au moment où vous faisiez partie d'un groupe de 40 villageois, à quel moment est-ce que cet événement a eu lieu?
That was not like that. I said that I fell into the pit with the same pit with my parents. And after I recovered from my unconsciousness, and then Tali told me to hide myself. And when I went into hiding in the forest, I saw about 40 people were taken to be killed. That's what I said.
So let me read to you an excerpt from that particular document. First, they relate the alleged killing of your family at the beginning of 75.
D'abord, concernant and then supposée de votre famille, début
they go on. In July 75,
ensuite, il est dit
around 40
villagers,
including 40 villageois, the applicant, you, were taken to be killed at the east foot of the Quebec mountain by an unknown militia controlled by Taping. So the report made by whomever, the victims unit support section, that's incorrect. You were not part of a group of 40 villagers when you were hit on the back. Is that correct?
Au moment où vous avez été frappé à la nuque, est-ce exact?
I said that I saw 40 people, and when I saw those 40 people, I was already injured on my back. And when I was hiding in the forest, Tali notified me that I should hide in the forest. And when I was in the forest, I saw around 40 people were taken. And that's what I said.
That's clear, Mr. Civil Party. Now, you also yesterday spoke about 2,000 Vietnamese families being relocated. Do you know what happened to these 2,000 Vietnamese families that you described yesterday? What happened to them?
I did not know.
Réponse, je ne savais pas.
They were classified into groups. Some were sent to Da, some were sent to Kaep Mountain, and those who were grouped in the fishing unit, they fished, and I did not know much because movement at that time was restricted.
Parce que mes mouvements à cette époque-là étaient restreints.
Maybe I was not accurate. Maybe you didn't say it yesterday, but you said it in your supplementary statement of your interview by your lawyer. You say, quote, there were about 2,000 Vietnamese families that were relocated up the mountain to Dar village. So just to be sure, I'm referring to those 2,000 Vietnamese village families who were relocated up the mountain to Dar village. What happened to them?
I do not know.
Réponse, je ne sais pas.
Let me now move on to when you were on the ferry going to Vietnam. And the things that you said about you and other Vietnamese people being quote unquote traded or bartered for salt and rice. Can you explain again why you thought you and the others were traded for rice and salt? What made you say that?
When I was on the ferry, that's what Ankar on the ferry said about that. They said that I was butter for salt and rice. That's what the Ankar on the ferry said.
Contre du riz et du sel.
Ankar cannot speak. Who was it that said that to you?
Question. L'Ankar ne peut pas parler. Qui vous a dit cela?
Those on the Vietnamese ferry.
Réponse, ceux qui étaient sur le ferry vietnamien.
So it was the Vietnamese Ankar or the Vietnamese who said that you were traded for rice. Is that what you're saying? So it wasn't Khmer person, but it was a Vietnamese person.
Khmer, mais bien des Vietnamiens. Do I understand correctly? Que j'ai bien compris.
Yes, that's correct.
Réponse, oui. C'est exact.
And of course, I presume you have no idea where this question, Vietnamese person had his knowledge from, correct?
Que vous ne savez pas d'où cette personne vietnamienne tenait ses informations, c'est exact.
Yes, that's correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
Just to confirm, you never heard that you were traded or bartered in Cambodia itself, or you were never told such a thing by a Khmer cadre. Is that correct?
Au Cambodge, de la bouche d'un cadre Khmer. Est-ce exact?
Bah.
Yes, of course. That's correct.
Réponse, oui. Bien sûr, c'est exact.
I'm finalizing my questions now, Mr. Sivaparthi.
Maître Pope, je vais conclure à présent mes questions.
Is it correct that you have
est-il exact?
Absolutely no idea what the reason was
que vous ne savez absolument
for
pas.
The alleged killing of your family by tapping.
Pourquoi votre famille a été exécutée par tapping?
Thường đừng ắt đăng hay ắt đăng mày. I didn't know about that.
Đăng vô.
I knew only that my family were taken away to be killed.
Avait été emmené pour être exécuté.
So then do you agree with me there is zero evidence to suggest that your family was killed because they were Vietnamese?
Exécuté parce qu'ils étaient vietnamiens.
Và khơi khơi nom mục đã trơn 3 4 tụnu hay nơi
bọt. Please deputy co-prosecutor.
Monsieur le co-procureur adjoint, allez-y.
So we noticed that the
plutôt, nous avons constaté
defense counsel have a very good questions.
Que la défense pose
please the
très bonne question.
Thank you, Mr. President. I object to the form of the question.
It's
certainly appropriate to ask the civil party whether he has any knowledge of why his family was killed, for him to opine on whether.
Deputy co-prosecutor, please be on your feet. The chamber would like to remind you again that you should not use this stage to teach another party how to put questions to the civil party. Of course, you can be on your feet and raise your objection, but it is not your turn to instruct the other party how to put questions to the civil party. And Mr. Civil Party, please do not respond to the last question put to you by the defense counsel.
Right. Mr. Civil Party, is it correct that you yourself have no other information at all about the reason for the arrest of your family?
Expliquant les raisons à l'origine de l'arrestation de votre famille.
President, the witness, you don't need to answer the to these leading questions.
Ne répondez pas à cette question orientée.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President.
Maître Coppe, oui, merci, Monsieur le Président.
President,
the floor is given
to
the defense
President,
team for Mr. Kyo Sompong to put questions to this civil party. You may now proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank
bonjour.
You, Mr. President. Good morning.
Bonjour, Monsieur Chung-Yen-Chet. Je m'appelle Antagise, je suis co-avocat international de Monsieur Kusampan. C'est à ce titre que je vais vous poser quelques questions complémentaires.
To put a few questions to you.
À l'audience d'hier, à 11h09, vous avez évoqué le départ de nombreuses familles de Kandal vers Dar.
To Dar,
en disant qu'elles étaient au nombre de 1000. C'est le chiffre que vous avez utilisé hier. Et vous avez également indiqué que parmi ces familles, il y avait à la fois des familles d'origine vietnamienne et des Khmer. Ma première question est de savoir comment vous avez eu ce chiffre de 1000 familles.
That was my estimation. I did not count.
C'était une estimation, la mienne.
That once I said 1,000 families, it came from my estimation.
J'ai dit 1,000 familles, c'est mon estimation.
Mais que vous avez estimé à partir de quoi? C'était un lieu de rassemblement? Comment est-ce que vous avez, sur quelle base vous avez fait cette estimation?
There was about one group, about 50 or 40 families, and there were many groups. So it, so I estimated. So it's from my estimation.
Et ce groupe sur lequel vous avez fait cette estimation, où se trouvait-il à ce moment-là?
Mau bị tay châu chân cung cho tỏ cái này ban cái sinh nhai đối với những phía em như thế này cái sinh nhai số nào làng lư làng
nhân
đồng bay làng lư
cũng là tam cũng là classify into groups and send to some to fishing and some to do other things.
J'ai bien compris que les personnes avaient été dispersées. Ma question est de savoir, au moment où vous avez fait votre estimation, où est-ce que ce groupe de personnes était situé, à quel endroit?
C'était
près de la rivière.
And when we went to the mountain at Kaep Mountain, Da Mountain, Chachanok Mountain, so those are the names of places.
Voilà les noms des endroits.
J'ai cru comprendre de vos réponses à M. le co-procureur et également à mon consoeur Copé, corrigez-moi si je me trompe, aurait été à l'origine de ces déplacements. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris votre déposition?
Only when I met him at the river and he told, instructed us to build shelter, but I did not know whether the Ping killed other people or not.
Alors, j'ai du mal à m'exprimer. Ma question était de savoir non pas si Tapin avait tué d'autres personnes, mais si c'était lui qui était à l'origine des déplacements des personnes de Kandal vers Dar.
Responsible for the movement of the people of Kandal to Dar.
Je n'ai pas eu de traduction à votre réponse. Il y a eu un problème.
Oui, c'était lui.
Donc vous venez de me confirmer que c'était Tapin qui était à l'origine de ces déplacements. Donc ma question est de savoir comment savez-vous que c'était lui qui était à l'origine de ces déplacements.
So how did you know that he was the person responsible for that?
My parents said Tapin evacuated us.
On dit que Tapin nous avait évacué.
My parents told me.
Et mes parents me l'ont dit.
Est-ce que vous savez s'il y a eu une annonce collective dans votre village d'origine pour annoncer ce transfert ou est-ce que ça s'est fait d'une autre manière? Est-ce que vous savez comment cette annonce s'est faite?
As I said,
à cette époque-là, il n'y a pas eu d'annonce.
They arrived at around 6 p.m.
and they said, "Long live the king, father." Longue vive le roi père.
And they burned houses that were unoccupied, and there was no any announcement at that time.
Il n'y a pas eu d'annonce faite à l'époque.
Donc, si je comprends bien, les gens sont simplement venus, ils vous ont dit allez à tel endroit, c'est ça?
Came to you and said, okay, you must go to such and such a place. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. During the evacuation, they said those who were on the ground walk on the ground, those who were on the water remain on the water.
Et qui a fait cette annonce?
And who made this announcement?
They wore black uniform with scarf around their necks.
Dans votre déclaration complémentaire, réalisée à la suite d'un entretien avec votre avocate, document E3-5631, ERN en français 00898972, ERN en Khmer 00897513, ERN en anglais 00678292. Au deuxième paragraphe, Voilà ce qui est indiqué. Environ 2000 familles vietnamiennes ont été envoyées dans la montagne, dans le village de Da. Environ 200 familles cambodgiennes ont été déplacées également. Elles ont été envoyées dans la montagne pour cultiver des terres. Environ 1000 familles sont restées dans les villages flottants pour pêcher du poisson pour les Khmer Rouges. Fin de citation. Là encore, ma question, monsieur de la partie civile, est de savoir le chiffre que vous avez indiqué, vous m'avez confirmé tout à l'heure que c'était une évaluation de 1000 personnes. Là, dans le document qui résulte de l'entretien avec votre avocat, vous dites 2000 familles. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous indiquer quel est le bon chiffre, si vous le savez?
Les deux chiffres sont corrects.
At that time, they were still on the floating village. They were not yet evacuated on land.
Dans le village flottant, ils n'avaient pas encore été évacués
and
sur
it was
terre.
Correct that about 1,000 families were evacuated on land.
Que 1000 familles ont été évacuées.
I said that before the evacuation, there were around 2,000 families.
Il y avait à peu près 2000 familles.
Avant l'évacuation, il y avait à peu près 2000 familles qui étaient à la fois vietnamiennes et khmer, n'est-ce pas? Enfin, d'origine vietnamienne et khmer.
Families, khmer and Vietnamese families mixed, is that correct?
Bah, my name?
Yes, that's correct.
Oui, c'est exact.
Donc, si je comprends bien, le chiffre de 2000 familles uniquement vietnamiennes telles qu'il figure dans votre déclaration complémentaire n'est pas correct.
I said only what I knew.
J'ai seulement dit ce que je savais.
Je me contenterai donc de cette réponse. Je voudrais maintenant passer à un autre point que vous avez abordé, que vous venez de me confirmer en disant que vous avez dit que lorsque les maisons ont été vidées pendant ce déplacement, un certain nombre d'entre elles ont été brûlées. Est-ce que c'est bien au moment où vous partez de votre village que cela s'est passé?
That's correct.
C'est exact.
Répondant, je crois, à une question de Madame le juge Fence, vous avez indiqué que votre livret de famille était conservé chez vous et que il aurait été détruit en même temps que votre maison. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris votre déposition?
Yes, you are right.
Oui, vous avez raison.
All my belongings were burnt at my house.
Tous mes biens ont été brûlés à ma maison.
J'ai compris aussi qu'à un moment, vous dites que les livrets de famille auraient été consultés par les autorités de l'époque. Est-ce que vous pouvez préciser à quel moment le livret de votre famille aurait été consulté et par qui?
At that time, I could not recognize. I could not remember.
Donc, quand vous avez dit à Monsieur le procureur que les livrets de famille ont été consultés, à quel événement faisiez-vous référence?
At Da Mountain.
Lorsque j'étais à Kampong Chnam, à la montagne de Da.
Mais vous parlez de quels livrets de famille qui ont été consultés? Celui de votre famille, hein?
The family record book of your family or?
Mm. As I said yesterday, my dad was in the family record books, and it was made during the previous regime, but during the Khmer Rouge regime, there was no record books made at that time.
Précédent, mais pendant le régime des Khmer Rouge, il n'y avait pas de
but livret. They made only a statistic and report about who's the head of the family and how many members in the family there are. That's only what the Khmer Rouge did.
Oui, mais hier, répondant à Monsieur le Co-procureur, j'avais compris de votre réponse que vous indiquiez que les Khmer Rouges, entre guillemets, avaient consulté les livrets de famille. Donc, ma question est de savoir est-ce que maintenant, ce que vous dites, ce n'est pas qu'il y avait une consultation des livrets de famille, mais que c'était des questions qui étaient posées. C'est ça que je dois comprendre de votre réponse.
C'est ça que je dois comprendre de votre réponse.
As I said, during the Khmer Rouge regime, they did not produce a family record book for us.
But
the family record book was made in the Lon Nol regime. During the Khmer Rouge regime, they made only the family reports, just want to know about who were the head of the family, who were members of the family. So it's different from the previous regime.
Hier, à 15h06 et 17 secondes, voilà la question qui vous est posée. Et les Khmer Rouges,
the Khmer Rouge,
ont-ils consulté ces lantai,
check these lantai or
ou ont-ils demandé à voir le lantai de la famille?
To see the lantai of the family.
Votre réponse a été la suivante. Ils ont consulté
they
le livret de famille, ils ont consulté tous les lantai. Fin de citation.
End of quote, free translation.
Donc ma question est de dire, est-ce que maintenant vous revenez sur votre déclaration et vous nous dites qu'ils n'ont pas consulté ces livrets de famille et qu'ils ont simplement posé des questions?
I talk about the Khmer Rouge asked about the family record books. So they wanted to know whether we were ethnic Khmer or Vietnamese or Cham, and that's what I said. And they wanted to see our family record book so that they can write down the names of our family members and how many members are there in the families.
Ça, j'ai bien compris qu'ils voulaient connaître le nombre. Ma question, donc, je la répète. Est-ce que, oui ou non, votre famille a montré votre livret de famille à une quelconque personne arrivée sur la montagne?
When you were up the mountain.
When we were at the mountain, there were no more
montagne,
family record books with us because it was burned down at our house when the house was burned.
Donc ma question est de savoir quand vous avez répondu à Monsieur le coprocureur hier que les Khmer Rouges avaient consulté le livret de famille, à quel moment faites-vous allusion?
What specific type were you referring to?
Just said that when we were in Kampong Chnam, and
Kampong
Chnam, they checked the family record book and they remember the family in that book. And of course, they had that family record book with them.
Bien évidemment, les familles avaient leur livret avec elles.
And as for Lang Tai, we actually had it with us.
Nous
However, when we were evacuated, our house was burned down along with our Lang Tai.
Incendié la maison et le Lang Tai a brûlé lui aussi.
Your Honor, these questions are unnecessary and repetitive. The evidence that came from this civil party yesterday was that the Lang Tai, the family record book, was kept by his mother in his family. And he said Whenever we moved villages, we had to show it. Now, there were a few different movements that have taken place. The first one is a movement from his place of birth, Saitokoi village, to Kandal village. The second movement, which was a forced movement, was from Kandal village to Dar village up Kangkep mountain. So, it's my submission, Your Honours, that these questions are unnecessary, have already been answered, and there is no need to cause confusion with further questions of this type.
Créer de la confusion en posant d'autres questions de ce type.
Là où ma consoeur voit de la confusion, moi je cherche des clarifications. C'est le principe même de l'interrogatoire de toutes les parties de la défense. Et quand il y a des choses qui apparaissent peu claires, on demande des clarifications. Donc je ne vois pas quel est le problème de ma consoeur sur ce point. J'essaye d'être tout à fait clair avec le témoin en lui rappelant ses déclarations, en lui demandant de réagir. Ce sont les explications plutôt de monsieur de la partie civile qui m'intéressent et non pas les explications de sa consoeur, de ma consoeur plutôt, qui aura le loisir de plaider si elle le souhaite en fin de course. Pour le moment, je cherche des clarifications de la part de la partie civile. En tout état de cause, j'ai entendu la réponse de monsieur de la partie civile et je continue. Hier, à l'audience à
11h13,
monsieur de la partie civile, vous avez évoqué la mort de vos parents en disant que votre mère, lorsque des personnes vous ont arrêté, aurait perdu connaissance ou aurait été en Khmer, c'est ce qui est apparemment ressorti en Khmer, aurait été exécutée dans la maison. Est-ce que vous pouvez préciser ce point et évoquer ce qui s'est passé au moment de l'arrestation de votre famille?
Yes, I can do that again.
Je peux le répéter.
Yesterday, what I stated was that they arrived at my house at 8 o'clock in the morning. They didn't ask us to leave the house, but actually they ordered us to leave the house, and each of us was tied with a separate rope. And then after all the family members were tied up, then we were tied in a file, and then the next family who lived next door were tied up, there were four of them. Then we were walked towards the pit, and then we were put in one place, and each of us at a time was walked to the pit and killed. I didn't know how those people were killed. However, when it's my turn, I saw the dead bodies of my parents in the pit. President, Mr. Civil Party, let me remind you again, please make your response as precise as possible to the question and do not provide a long question. A long response, rather, otherwise you would be questioned based on what you say.
On vous posera des questions sur ce que vous avez dit.
And Defense Counsel Gusset, please repeat your last question. It seems that his response is far from your question.
La réponse de la partie civile ne correspond pas à ce que vous lui avez demandé.
Hier, à l'audience, en Khmer, à 11h13, vous avez parlé de l'arrestation de votre famille et il est ressorti en Khmer que vous avez dit que votre mère avait été exécutée à votre domicile. Est-ce que vous pouvez dire si c'est le cas, oui ou non?
Yes, that is indeed the case.
No, I did not say some lap. I said she was some lap in Khmer, means she became unconscious.
J'ai dit some lap, elle est tombée sans connaissance.
She did not die in the house, but she became unconscious.
Elle a perdu connaissance.
Est-ce que vous pouvez indiquer quelles étaient les personnes qui ont procédé à cette arrestation et combien ils étaient?
Who arrested you and exactly how many people arrested
I did not know their names. However, there were eight of them with eight guns.
Ils avaient huit fusils.
And then there was a bamboo club and
une matraque
an
en bambou
axe.
Et une hache.
Ces huit personnes, est-ce que vous les aviez déjà vues auparavant?
Had you already seen those eight people before?
No, I did not.
Vous ne savez donc pas s'ils étaient des miliciens, des soldats, ni de quel ressort ils étaient, à savoir soit de la commune, du village ou du district. Vous ne savez pas. Est-ce que c'est correct?
The village or the district.
They were the best people.
C'était des
they
gens
were
du
the soldiers.
C'était
soldats. Rather, they were the Khmer Rouge, but they were not militia.
Ce n'était pas les soldats. L'interprète se reprend. C'était des Khmer Rouge, mais ce n'étaient pas des miliciens.
Et qu'est-ce qui vous fait dire cela? Quelle était la différence
and
entre des
so?
Personnes de la population de base et les miliciens?
Base people and militia men.
Base people wore black clothing with a scarf around their neck.
Une écharpe autour du cou.
Et quel était l'uniforme ou quels étaient les vêtements des miliciens qui auraient été différents?
By militiamen, which would have made the difference.
They were ordinary clothes.
Ils portaient des vêtements ordinaires.
Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Vêtements ordinaires, est-ce que vous pouvez les décrire?
What do you mean by ordinary clothes? Can you describe that to us?
It was the clothing as we are wearing at the present time. It means that they wore all those clothes.
C'est donc des vêtements comme ça.
J'ai bien compris votre déposition. Vous voulez dire que les miliciens portaient des vêtements comme aujourd'hui, alors que les gens du peuple de base étaient habillés avec des vêtements noirs et un foulard autour du cou. C'est bien ça?
Wore black attire with a scarf around their necks. Is that indeed what you're saying?
Vous avez indiqué avoir été amené, si j'ai bien compris votre déposition, à un kilomètre de Dar.
You said if
est-ce que c'est bien exact? C'était un kilomètre que vous avez parcouru avec votre famille jusqu'au lieu où vous avez vu les deux fosses dont, que vous avez évoquées hier.
Is that the distance you covered with your family to the place where you saw the two pits?
I walked in a field with my family members.
Nous.
However,
moi et
we
ma famille
were
marchons en
stopped at an area which was
et
about 100 meters from the pit, and then each of my family members was taken to be killed at the pit, and I was the last person to be taken and killed.
Pour être tué.
Ma question était de savoir ce lieu se trouve bien à un kilomètre de Dar, c'est bien exact?
That place is situated at a distance of 1 kilometer from where you were before. Is that correct?
My name?
Yes.
Oui.
J'en viens maintenant à lorsque vous vous êtes réveillé vivant et que vous avez pu sortir de la fosse.
And you were
vous avez indiqué que
to come out of the pit.
Le président.
President, thank you, Council.
Merci, maître.
It is now convenient for us to take a short break.
We
take a break now and resume at 10:30.
On prendra à 10h30.
And court officer, please assist the civil party at the waiting room reserved for civil parties and witnesses, and invite him back into the courtroom at 10:30. The court is now in recess.
Suspension des
deux. Something, Krakow.